Hi, my name is Michelle Jones, and I'm so glad you stopped by for a minute. I was just sitting here pondering a great question from a person named Simon Sinek. If you are not aware of who he is, you really should Google him. Simon Sinek, S-I-N-E-K. The question he asked is this: what is more important, intensity or consistency? So in life, what is more important, intensity or consistency? Now, to help you wrap your mind around this question that I was pondering, here's some examples. Is it more important to be intense and go to the gym 8 hours once a month, or to be consistent and do it 20, 30 minutes a day? Is it more important to be intense and go get that deep cleaning at the dentist twice a year, or be consistent and brush your teeth every morning and night for 2 minutes? Well, hearing the question asked that way, obviously you're gonna say, duh, Michelle, it is consistency is more important. And it's something that so many people struggle with. I have been in the profession of helping other people now for over a decade, and I hear it again and again and again. I just want to be more consistent. This month I'm going to be more consistent. This week I'm going to be more consistent. Oh my gosh, it's a brand new year. I'm going to be more consistent. So let's just do it. For my family, for my business, this is something that we've been working on, really jumped in the last couple of years, and things have exploded by changing this one thing of being more consistent. So you're probably sitting on your seat, the edge of your seat, going, okay, Michelle, what is it that you've done? You know, give me a little nugget. Well, guess what? I'm gonna give you 5 nuggets about being more consistent. 5 nuggets. Really, when I think back and think, what happened for me? Why was it that I was able to become more consistent? How is it that people around me, friends and family and, you know, business partners, right? Why are they becoming more consistent? It boils down to 5 little nuggets. Okay, nugget number one, oh my gosh. You just have to laser focus, keep your eye on your why. Like I'm looking right now, keep your eye on your why. Why is it that you want to do this? Now the example that I gave of going to the gym, if you want to be healthier, if you want to lose weight, if you want to be, you know, more toned, you got to keep your eye on your why. Why are you doing something? As I go through these 5 nuggets, though, I want to share it in the aspect of your network marketing business or your relationship marketing business or a business that you have. So keep your eye on your why. Bullet point number one, why do you do your business? What are your hopes? What are your dreams? What are your goals? I know for me, keeping my eye on my why was figuring out how to replace an income, a great income that I had when I was in corporate America, to allow me to be a stay-at-home mommy with that same kind of income. My why at the time was to figure this out, to be able to be a stay-at-home mommy. Now, everyone's why is different. Don't compare yourself to me. Maybe your why is just to get to the end of the month and make bills for the month, right? Everyone's why is different, but bullet point number one, you've got to keep your eye on your why. Number two, and they're all important, okay? Bullet point number two is you got to pick your battle, not battles. Okay, you got to pick your battle, not battles. In regards to relationship marketing and direct sales, what does that mean? That means you tend to get scattered. That means you tend to go, okay, I'm going to start doing this every day, and I'm going to start doing this every day, and I'm going to start doing this every day, and guess what? You don't, and you're not consistent, and you kind of let yourself down, you think, or you feel a little blue about it. No, let's change that. Bullet point number two, you've got to pick your battle, not battles. So what is a battle? Well, in our industry of relationship marketing, a battle is talking to people every day. So that is the battle that you need to pick, and you need to make it happen every single day. Every single day you need to talk to someone about your business. Now, if you're new in our profession, you might go, that's the best tip ever. Or if you've been around a while, you might say, Michelle, you know, I struggle with finding enough people to do that. I have training on that. I have so much training. So you can just reach out to me and I'll get you information on that. But number two was to pick your battle, not battles. You got a laser clear focus on what it is that you want to do to be more consistent, and just do that again and again and again. Because the coolest thing is when you master that, you know what? You can pick another thing and start to become consistent about that. Now number three, nugget number three. You got to schedule it in. You can't hope. You can't maybe, you can't want, you can't, oh, maybe I'll do it. You gotta schedule it in. Every single person in life has things that you do on a daily basis, a weekly basis, that are scheduled in no matter what. If you're a college student and you're watching this, you have to show up to class. If you have a job and you're watching this, you have to show up to your job. We all have things we have to show up for that we scheduled in. Your network marketing and direct sales business is exactly the same. You have to schedule it in to your calendar. I know you've probably heard this, and some of you are like, yeah, I'll do it when I get time. No, bullet point number three, nugget number three, is you have to schedule it in. What does that mean? I'll just kind of give you a quick example of a couple day period for me. Mondays are crazy in my life with my kids and activities and, you know, things that are going on. But every single Monday, I have scheduled in my calendar Monday afternoon, that I am going to reach out to people about my business every single Monday afternoon. And then I look at Tuesday and I think I'm scheduling it in. Tuesday mornings work out great for me. So there's a scheduled chunk of time in my calendar, just like if it was a doctor's appointment, if it was a dentist appointment, it's scheduled in my calendar. Wednesday, I have a scheduled time of Wednesday evening. So we got an afternoon, we got a morning, we got an evening. Thursday over lunchtime. If you have a full-time job and you're building your side hustle, your side business, you know what? Thursday, or just take your week and kind of do what I'm doing. Thursday, I like to do something over lunchtime. Friday, I kind of zip back to early in the daytime. Saturday mornings, I have an hour chunk of time every Saturday morning that I work my business. So schedule it in. It has to be, if you are old school and you still have like a calendar that opens, schedule it in. If you know, use your iPhone or your Android or whatever cool device you have, you've got to put it in your calendar. You have to schedule it in. And oh my gosh, like, it seems so simple. Like, bullet point number three seems so simple, but I didn't used to do it before I had success. Before I had a large team and a large organization, I didn't do it, and thank goodness someone trained me and shared this information with me, and I'm like, that's it, I'm gonna rip the band-aid and I'm gonna schedule it in, and no matter what, I'm doing it. That schedule's not gonna be adjusted. Okay, number four. Oh, number four is a good one. You have your why. You've chose your battle, not battles. You've scheduled it in, and now you're sitting down to do this, okay? You have to ignore your feelings right then at that moment. Because a lot of times when you've scheduled it in, and it's that time and you're starting to do it, your mind will kick in, and you'll have maybe some negative self-talk, or you'll think of reasons why not to. So bullet point number four, to become more consistent, you have to ignore the negative feelings, the negative self-talk. You have to ignore the reasons that might be coming up. And there's so many of them. Like, there's so many things. I just think back, like, I would think, you know, oh, this isn't a good time to reach out to people. Or I would think, oh, I need more training. Or, you know, I would think, why does someone want to hear from me? That's all gone. You ignore your feelings in the moment and you do what you said you were going to do. You keep your eye on your why. You go forward with it. You know, I think of bullet point number four, ignoring your feelings in the moment. Your body's kind of, you know, goal is to conserve energy. So anytime something makes you a little nervous or a little uncomfortable, even though it's a great thing for you to be doing, your body's going to, like, your mind and your body are going to go, well, I'd rather sit on the couch. I'd rather watch another Netflix. Like, I don't even understand what's happened to our society. How is it cool to, like, be on Facebook and watch and say, you know, I watched 12 seasons of blah, blah, blah show on Netflix? That, like, blows my mind. If you're doing that, that's probably affecting your consistency. But your mind is going to say, you know, come up with every reason for you not to do it. So in that moment, when you've scheduled it in, when you've committed to yourself, you are going to ignore those feelings and you're going to do it anyway. Now, bullet point number five. This made a huge difference for me in life and my business, is you've got to be thankful for where you are. You've got to be thankful for where you are and realize you have the power for more. I'm going to say that again. I'm going to get a little closer. You got to be thankful for where you are and realize that you have the power for more. You have the power for more, okay? So what does this really mean? It means every morning and night, just take a minute. When you're laying your head down on the pillow at night, or when you're waking up in the morning, take a minute and be thankful for where you are. No matter, like, maybe how hard things are right now, right? You have to find things that you're thankful for. You know, earlier today I was at the store, and where I live, it's raining and it's cold today, and there's this homeless guy, and you know, he was begging for money. You know, so when I'm saying be thankful for where you are, if you have a roof over your head, right, that's being thankful for where you are, right? If, you know, you have a car and you're driving down the street, that's being thankful for where you are. Now, some of you have a lot more you can say you're thankful for, but in the beginning it was really hard for me to go, okay, but I want all these things, you know, and what I have right now is kind of like, I want these things and what I have right now is here, right? Why should I even be thankful? And I'm just telling you, the way it works is when you be thankful for where you are, every morning when you wake up, think of a couple of things where you're thankful. Do you have someone in your life, your spouse, a friend, a mom, a cousin, a neighbor that is amazing, and be thankful for them, right? Do you have a job that even though maybe you don't love it, it's paying the bills, be thankful for that. So every morning, you need to think about that. Every night before you go to bed, you need to think about that. Just be thankful for where you are, and then I'll tell you what starts to happen. You start to realize you do have some power here. You have some power for more. You have power for the future to be better. You really do. When I started in our profession, you know, I just wondered, could I do this? Like, everything I'm sharing with you is things that I've learned from great people along the way, this decade journey that I've had in life, and I'm here to tell you, you absolutely can do it. If you are watching this video, right, that tells me you absolutely can do it. If you enjoyed our little chunk of time together, I do so much training. I do training every single day. I put content out there. I put information out there for you just to grow, for you to expand, for you to, you know, have all those things you want in life. So if you enjoyed this and you want more, just click on the button on this page and you'll get more of me. Thank you.